true spirit of the holidays, President Trump brought the world together in universal condemnation of America.
Breaking news, President Trump has had his first major defeat at the United Nations. The United Nations Security Council voting 14-1 on a resolution sponsored by Egypt to reject the Trump doctrine on Jerusalem being the capital of Israel.
His second major defeat, actually. There's also that time he tried to rebrand the UN building as a Trump property. Yes, our national bowl full of jelly in chief didn't stop with ending the war on Christmas. He also might give us a war for Christmas. Turns out there are more people who think it's a good idea to lick a frozen flagpole than think it's a good idea for the U.S. to declare what Israel's capital should be.
The announcement was met with widespread condemnation.
63% of all Americans don't want the U.S. embassy moved to Jerusalem.
He was cautioned not to do it by advisors.
Rex Tillerson, James Mattis, and H.R. McMaster all promoted the status quo.
Even the Pope spoke out, saying that he prayed that wisdom and prudence would prevail.
Please pray harder. He is not getting wiser. While world leaders and American citizens may be shocked by this move, there is one group of people who are not, Palestinians.
Yes, Trump has declared Jerusalem as the capital of Israel, but for 5 decades, the United States has been facilitating Israel's takeover of Jerusalem.
So this move won't destroy Palestinians' belief in America because they never had any in the first place. Yay! If there's two things you can always safely bet on, it's the Harlem Globetrotters are gonna win and Palestinians are getting screwed. So who pushed Trump to make this massively unpopular move? In addition to pleasing a few powerful donors like two-week-old balloon Sheldon Adelson, there is a very focused, very passionate group that has been lobbying presidents on this for years. They're not Trump's base. They're the basiest part of the base of his base. A Trump-supporting fundamentalist death cult called Christian Zionists. And boy, are they excited about this!
Many evangelicals believe that the land of Israel will play a key role in the future, the final battleground between good and evil until the end of the world, at which time the believers will be raptured or taken away to heaven.
Trump has truly signaled the end times. His name will be recorded in eternity as the leader who brought about the will of God in this generation.
This is a prophecy alert, a prophecy alert. President Trump will recognize that Jerusalem is the capital of Israel.
Prophecy alert, cloudy with a chance of end times. You heard them right. This bunch of fringe-dwelling internet lunatics think that Trump's gambit might hasten the end of the world, and they are into it. Christian fundamentalist predictions about the end times seem like a movie that's got the violence of Quentin Tarantino, belief system of Mel Gibson, and unhinged intensity of the fourth hour of the Today Show. They believe that Israel has to be united and Jewish so Jews can rebuild their holy temple in Jerusalem at the Temple Mount. Since this site is currently in disputed territory and has a 1,000-year-old mosque on it, this requires nudging some Palestinians out of the way. So essentially, Christian fundamentalists want to get rid of Muslims so that Jews can form a human target for the Antichrist and the world can end. In my church, we all just said, "Peace be with you," and went home and ate sandwiches. These specific crazies don't have any real influence on the president, but this one does. Meet Pastor John Hagee.
I was curious about some of your interactions with the president.
We spoke about what his thoughts were about moving the embassy. I said, this is the year to move the embassy and make that declaration because it is a biblical timing of absolute precision.
Of course, Armageddon is the one thing that Trump happens to get done with absolute precision. Hagee is a frequent guest of Trump's White House and the leader of Christians United for Israel, the largest pro-Israel group in America. He also presides over 20,000 congregants in Texas, I think.
Now, Pastor, what is going on here? We're in a Christian conservative church, and it looks like a little bit of Israel.
It looks like a little bit of Israel the way Olive Garden looks like a little bit of Italy. And if you think their creepy murder suicide crush on Jews is bad, what Hagee's crew think about Muslims is exactly what you're imagining.
This is why it's this anti-Christian sentiment is growing in the Middle East. is because it is the doctrine of the Prophet Muhammad.
We're fighting what is behind the Muslim people, which is Satan. Because Satan is the one who's actually trying to destroy the Jewish race. Because that way he would destroy God's plan.
Oh my God, lady, even Satan is like, leave me out of this. I am not that Islamophobic. Kufi conferences are full of people so fucking excited for the rapture, you'd think it was a guns slash Twinkie sale.
Are you looking forward to Armageddon?
I definitely am.
So you're looking forward to Armageddon?
Looking forward to Armageddon and looking forward to the cleansing of the earth.
Are you guys looking forward to the rapture?
Amen. Amen. Well, I got a bag packed.
You can't take a bag, dummy. Even I know that. Jesus wants you naked, remember? I assume for some type of orgy. This nonsense isn't good for anybody, especially not Palestinians who find their fate in the hands of an Aryan death cult half a world away for no good goddamn reason. Look, does Trump genuinely believe in fundamentalist Christian prophecy?
Grab him by the pussy.
That's a no. But he does believe in people worshiping him. So what better group of people to pander to than the ones who are already super good at worshiping? Enjoy Christmas, everyone. If Trump's friends have it their way, it could be our last one. We'll be right back.